God is good
all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Sisters and brothers, today the Lord has inspired me to preach about decision making. The prayer of Job is, after arguing a lot, he is telling, teach me. Let's pray together. Teach me and I will be silent. Make me understand how I have gone wrong. This is our God, where when you ask Him, using your free will, your freedom that the Lord has given you, and asking Him, Lord, can you please help me to take decision in my life? Show me your will. Because we read in 1 John 2:17, those who do the will of God will live forever. Let's repeat this word of God. The world and its desire are passing away, but those who do the will of God live forever. So what's the most important thing? First of all, to know that the Lord who created you, He is interested in directing you, in giving you direction in your life, in giving you proper decision in your life. But only when you ask, not what you think inside, because God respects your great freedom. That's why we read again, this is in Revelation chapter 3 verse 20, the word of God says, behold, I stand at the door and knocking. If you open, I will enter. If you open, not if you don't open. That means the first thing that we need to do, if you are struggling in a decision making, you don't know what is the way, the first thing, we have to seek God's will. And if we seek God's will, He Himself said He will direct us. Again, in Matthew chapter 7 verse 7, He said, ask and you will receive. Knock and the door will be opened. Search and you will find. And it is God's word. Let's repeat this word of God. Ask and it will be given you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be open for you. I have heard a testimony of a particular girl. Her dad and mom were separated because of some misunderstanding. But this girl, she was very upset because of the separation of the parents. She came to know the dad cannot move along with the mother. But she also has a younger brother. But the mother and these two children, they are of one set, that they think similarly, but her dad is thinking differently. So she noticed it, and eventually the dad had gone away. Then the religious sister with whom she was doing the catechism told, if you have an intention, you have to pray with rosary every day. Put that intention and pray. And she said, as a little girl, she started to pray daily the rosary with an intention of bringing her dad back who was separated. And as she started to pray more than for 1 month continuously, and she said, miraculously, the dad came back. And she came back, and the dad came back and joined with the mother. And she said, that was the most beautiful thing happened in her life. And she said, I asked, I prayed, and the Lord gave me the answer. Sisters and brothers, it's Jesus Himself who said, ask and it will be given to you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. And the most important thing is to know the will of God. We should know this particular thing that we are doing, this particular decision that we are taking, is it from God? This is the most important thing. That is why even the disciples, they were struggling. Everyone who are living, even me as a priest, it should come from God. So what we need to do? Keep on asking. Some Bible scholars say, in Greek where it is originally written, it says, not just ask, keep on asking, keep on searching, keep on knocking. Not just ask once, or not just search once, not just knock once, but we have to continuously do it, and the door will be open. It's promise, because He Himself said, give heed to my reproof and I will pour out my thoughts to you. It is His promise. And we are all given. And the greatest means that the gift that He has given us is His word. For example, see that there are people who always say that I have not given, nobody, even my parents have not given me the property. I have not given the family possession. I am just being sent away from home without giving me the portion of my father's property, the paternal property. There are people who say that I am given just a little, not as much as my dad has given to my brother or my sister. I'm always being sidelined. But we have to know, we have a God who has given us a great possession. We read this is in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 33 verses 3 and 4. Deuteronomy 33, 3 and 4. Indeed, O favorite among peoples, all His holy ones were in your charge. They marched at your heels, accepted direction from you. See, the word of God is telling, there are people who lived on this earth. The favorite people, what do? They accepted direction from God. So there are, even when you have not gotten the property or something that has happened, remember, when you get the direction from God, you are getting that real possession from God. We continue verse 4 and we continue to read. Moses charged us with the law as a possession for the assembly of Jacob. See, Moses has given us the law. The law is from God, and we know the law for the Old Testament. The law is the word of God, and this is the same for us. The law means the Bible, the word of God, God's word, as a possession for the assembly of Jacob. So today, as we are struggling to take a decision in our life or to get a direction, the Lord is telling, God has already given us a free direction through the word of God. And this is not just for Jacob, because we read now, this is Sirach chapter 44 verses 23. Sirach 44:23. And if it is given to Jacob, it is written as given to Jacob, he made to rest on the head of Jacob, he acknowledged him with his blessings and gave him his inheritance. He divided his portions and distributed them among 12 tribes. That means the inheritance, that is the word of God, the law that was given to Jacob, he did not keep it for himself. He passed it to all of us. That means the first tool in taking a decision in our life is to receive the possession, the inheritance the Lord has given. That is the word of God itself. If it was just the word of God for the Old Testament, for us in the New Testament, the holy sacraments, the indwelling presence of the Holy Trinity inside us, is our greatest inheritance, greatest possession. So today, if anybody is thinking that I am struggling, I am financially poor because my parents, my grandparents, they did not give me the proper inheritance, the proper paternal property or the possession, the Lord is telling, what more you need? I myself is inside you, and I myself is going to guide you. Sisters and brothers, this is what we read in Isaiah 30, 20 and 21. The Holy Spirit who is inside you, he's telling, is not just like your dad or mom who is giving you the direction. It's God who is inside you. We read together, though the Lord may give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet your teacher will not hide himself anymore. But your eyes shall see your teacher. And we read, and when you turn to the right, and when you turn to the left, your ears shall hear a word behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it. Sisters and brothers, we can have so many testimonies of people hearing this voice. This is the course you have to take. This is the career you have to choose. this is the person that you have to marry. He can even give you the name, he can show you the person, because he speaks what we need to do, ask. And I have already told you, not just ask once, keep on asking. And anyone who is asking, our God will never disappoint us. Because why we ask? Because we have to do the will of God. And the best prayer we can pray for anyone who is asking, maybe now your daughter is struggling to get married, or your son is struggling to get a university or an admission or a particular course, and you have to move from one place to the other for a job, you are struggling and somebody has asked you for a prayer. And what kind of prayer you can do? Saint Paul prayed a beautiful prayer. This is Colossians chapter 1 verse 9. This is the prayer he is praying, so that those who ask prayer, his people may take the proper decision according to the will of God. Let's pray this prayer together. For this reason, since the day we heard it, we have not ceased praying for you and asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. Saint Paul's prayer is that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. God's will. What is God's will? It will help us to take decision that has prepared by God for you, to know God's will. Sisters and brothers, to know God's will, how to know what is God's will? Now, even the apostles, the Pharisees, they asked Jesus this question. This is John chapter 6 verses 28 and 29. They came and they asked Jesus, what is the work? What we have to do? What must we do to perform the works of God? What must we do? What is your will? Then Jesus answered them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So the first step, if anybody wanted struggling to take a decision in their life, to know the will of God, to struggling to hear his voice, we know God speaks, he directs, he helps us to take a decision. We know it. And in order to know what does he wants us personally for our life, what we need to do? The first thing, to do the work of God, to do the will of God, to believe in God, to believe in Jesus. And this faith will transform us in taking decision. Because we read now, this is the faith that we need, is the faith that of Abraham. This is Hebrews chapter 11 verse 19. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 19. The faith of Abraham. Let's read together. He considered the fact that God is able even to raise someone from the dead. And figuratively speaking, he did receive him back. What is this faith? Abraham is taking his only son Isaac to sacrifice. And now, why he is doing this? Because he had such a faith that he considered the fact that God is able even to raise someone from the dead. That means even if he is sacrificing his only son Isaac, he had such a strong faith that my God is able to bring back my son back to life. Because how he got a child? Because he never forgot the fact, this is Romans chapter 4 from 19 we read, that Abraham, physically speaking, means externally speaking, he had no capacity to bring forth a child from his body. He did not weaken in faith when he considered his own body, which was... Do you also follow that way? That means our faith is not the faith that God wants. He will lift us up. We have so many testimonies of people who were humble and endured with prayer, and eventually God promoted them. See the life example of Joseph the patriarch. He had all the opportunity to do any kind of sin with Potiphar's wife, but he decided not to commit sin and God prospered him. Even the people whom he helped, they turned against him. But the Lord prospered him. And that prosperity was an everlasting prosperity. So today, the Lord wants us, when He wants us to take a decision, the Lord, the first thing, we need faith. Even the faith of this old man. Let's read, this is 2 Maccabees chapter 6 verse 30. When he was being put to death for keeping his faith, for not abandoning the old ways of his life, then they decided to throw him to the fire, to kill him. Then he said, this is a very important prayer, means a word of God. When he was about to die under the blows, he groaned aloud and said, "It is clear to the Lord in His holy knowledge that though I might have been saved from death, I am enduring terrible sufferings in my body under this beating. But in my soul, I am glad to suffer these things because I fear Him." Sisters and brothers, it's clear to the Lord in His holy knowledge that though I might have been saved from death. See, if he denies God, he can save his earthly life. But he says, my God can see that in my heart I fear him, that I don't want to deny him. Sisters and brothers, how many times we have this opportunity wherever we are, that in the office, in the workplace, that sometimes we are ashamed or we are afraid to acknowledge our God or do His will, to proclaim our faith. That's why we are not able to discern the will of God. We are not able to listen to His voice because we always compromise in our faith. So the first thing to hear His voice, to make a decision in accordance with God's will, is the first thing is to have unlimited faith in God. That's why the disciples kept on praying. Luke 17:5, after having all these miracles, they came to know it's important to know God's will, and they started to pray continuously, "Lord, increase our faith." Let's pray this three times together. Lord, increase our faith. Lord, increase our faith. Lord, increase our faith. If we have faith that the Lord can intervene in my life, that He does everything for my good, and He is working for me, that He is for me. This is what that we were singing in the adoration, the final song of blessing. The beauty of this song of blessing, this is completely, this is word of God. And the word of God that we were claimed, that the Lord is for you. He is for you. He is for you. And believe it. He is for you, and He will not change that. That is Psalm chapter 56 verse 9. And this is what we were claiming in that song. This is what you should have, the faith that He is for you. "Then my enemies will retreat in the day when I call. This I know, that God is for me." This is what that you have to believe. Even when you are childless, jobless, having financial crisis, you are unmarried, you don't have a job, you are working and not getting a salary, believe that God is for you. I do remember a person who gave a testimony in our retreat center. His testimony was that when he was in class 5, he was telling, he was just class 10, he started taking little alcohol. By 15, he started drinking more. And he said, even he got married. Now when he is giving testimony, he is 50 years old. More than 35 years, he drank alcohol, even after his marriage. And he hated God. He was always getting angry, irritated with his wife, because his joy was in alcohol. So those who have been obsessed, those who have been intoxicated with alcohol, they cannot have even any kind of pleasure or joy, even in a relationship with his wife. So he was always irritated. He was a person of lot of anger. That's the time one of his friends who is in the neighborhood inspired him, "Why can't you go and attend a retreat?" Then when he went for the retreat, he had no interest. They said, "Once you go there, you cannot drink." But because his friend, he kept on praying and kept on insisting, "You just come, I will pay all the money." Because he said his friend will take all the money. Some people are like this. When they are offered something free, they will go and do it. He said, just because my friend was irritating me, insisting me, and he said he'll take all the expenses. So I went for the retreat. And during the retreat, the priest asked, why did you come here? What is your need? Then he asked to everyone, just say, what is your need? Then he started to remember and he said, I want to stop drinking. It is because of this, I don't have love in my family. My children, they are afraid of me. My wife does not love me. I don't feel love to them. There is a lot of problem and I want to stop. And he said, when he decided, the Lord gave him the grace. And he said, since then, he has stopped drinking. And he started to say, confess that there are many things that he was doing along with this alcohol. Addiction to so many filthy, bad habits. Addiction to bad movies. He stopped it. And he openly said he had no interest in attending Holy Mass. He used to talk against the priest. Then when he stopped alcohol, he had the desire to attend the Holy Mass. Even on weekdays. He was not even going for Sunday Mass. But when he stopped this alcohol, he had this desire to receive him every day. Then he came. When he stopped drinking alcohol, he came to know, this is God's will that I should stop this. And this is God's will, I should go and receive him, which is more powerful than any alcohol. It is God's presence. And he said, now he is bringing so many people back to God. It's when he stopped this habit, he came to know the Lord is with him. The Lord is protecting him. Now he said, the same people who were looking with contempt on me is looking at me with great respect today. Now I am running a prayer group. I am bringing people to God. The same people who rejected me, now they started appreciating me because when I stopped this alcohol, the Lord stood beside me. Sisters and brothers, it is when you come to the Lord, you will know that He is for you. Even when you are an alcoholic, even when you are in this mess in your life, He will stand for you. You need this strong faith that He is for you and He will transform your life. And the second thing, this is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verses from 16. This is the will of God that you have to, 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 to 18, rejoice always, pray unceasingly, give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. So the second important thing, the first thing to believe in God, that He is there for you. And the second thing is that give thanks in all circumstances. That means whatever may be your situation. Maybe you are jobless, you are in trouble, your family is at the brink of breaking. But you need to do what? First thing, rejoice. And pray without ceasing. Continuous prayers. Monica prayed 18 years. She did not stop. She did not listen to anyone. She prayed and prayed. If there is anyone who is praying unceasingly, there is an answer. Because God will intervene in their life. And we need to give thanks. This is Job chapter 1 verses 21 and 22. What is the greatness and the speciality of Job? He said together, naked I came from my mother's womb,
and naked shall I return there.
The Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all this, Job did not sin or charge God with wrongdoing. Sisters and brothers, if you are sick, if you are healthy, if you are poor, if you are wealthy, whatever may be the situation in your life, believe God knows it. So what we need to do? Give thanks to God, praise Him, and never charge God with wrongdoing. Because we know in the life of Job, behind him, it was God's hand. He knows everything. Without His knowledge, nothing can happen. So in order to do God's will, to know what He wants, the Lord is teaching us through the word of God what he has given unto us. You just do one important thing, that you have to give thanks to God. Because Job again said, this is 19 chapter 19 verses 26 and 27. What did he say? He said, and after in skin has been thus destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold and not another. My heart faints within me. Job is telling that I am suffering now, and I have sickness all over my body, but after my skin has been thus destroyed, after I have suffered a lot, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold and not another. And why God has permitted all these things to Job? Today when we look at it, we know it was not just for Job, but also for you and me. In the suffering that we endure, sufferings with thanksgiving, without murmuring, without complaining, that it's my wife who caused it, it's my husband who caused it, it's my children who caused it. When we take it from God's hand like Job, we will see him. We will see the Lord standing beside us. See, Job did not charge anyone. Job did not accuse his friends who kept on accusing him. He listened to God, to know God's will. We read this is again in the book of Job. This is chapter 31 to 33. Chapter 33, verses from 31. Let's read this important word of God. Pay heed, Job. Listen to me. Be silent. And I will speak. So today, all those who wanted to know God's will and to know what God is telling, the Lord is directing us through the life of Job. The Lord is telling, pay heed, Job. You know, put your name where it is written, Job. Pay heed. Listen to me. Be silent and I will speak. We continue. If you have anything to say, answer me. Speak, for I desire to justify you. Then verse 33. If not, listen to me. Be silent, and I will teach you wisdom. See, this is the direction. If you listen to me, if you are silent, I will teach you wisdom. And now Job, he started to listen to the Lord, and he is receiving the wisdom of the Lord. That is the direction of God. This is what we read in Job chapter 40 verses 3 and 4. Job chapter 43 and 4. Let's read. Then Job answered the Lord. See, I am of small account. What shall I answer you? Lay my hand on my mouth. See, this great man of God, he's telling, I'm of small account. What shall I answer you? Because we don't know what happened before our birth. And we don't know what will happen after our birth. And even we don't know what happened when we were in the womb of the mother. There are things that we don't know are more than what we know. We know very little things. And Job came to know in the process, when he kept silence, that he is of small account. That he don't have any answer. He does not have any answer. And I lay my hand on my mouth. And we read then verse 9. And he made this conclusion, verse 9. Have you an arm like God? And can you thunder with a voice like his? See, all these things he comes to know, that his arm is a perishable arm, but his God has an arm that is imperishable, that has unlimited force and power, that can do anything. The hand, the arm of God. And he said, this is now 42 verse 2. Job continued to acknowledge something that's very important. He said, Job 42, 2. I know that you can do all things, and that no purpose of yours can be thwarted. No purpose of God can be blocked. Now, When Job gave thanks to God, give thanks to God in all circumstances, to know the will of God, and this is the will of God. And when Job started to do this, he came to realize that my God will establish everything for me. He is standing there for me. He is behind this particular suffering that I am going through, and he is going to fulfill his will in my life. As he started to give thanks to God again, in order to, again he said, in his crisis, this is Job chapter 23 verse 10. Job 23 verse 10. He acknowledged that he knows the way that I take. When he has tested me, I shall come out like gold. That means Job is a good example of doing God's will. The first thing, he believed in God. And the second thing is that he gave thanks in the midst of his suffering, because he knew that God will bring him out of this particular suffering. And we read verse 14, and he himself acknowledged, verse 14, same chapter, "For he will complete what he appoints for me, and many such things are in his mind." So, sisters and brothers, the Lord, what he has already prepared for you, he will fulfill it when we give thanks to God in all circumstances. And the third aspect to know, to do the will of God, is to pray for, the gift of wisdom, and basically pray for Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit to guide you. We read in the book of Wisdom, this is chapter 9, 13 and 14. This is Wisdom chapter 9, 13 and 14. Let's read together. "For who can learn the counsel of God, or who can discern what the Lord wills?" 14. "For the reasoning of mortals is worthless, for our designs are likely to fail." Then verse 17 we read. "Who has learned your counsel unless you have given wisdom and sent your Holy Spirit from on high?" Now the word of God is categorically teaching us why many are struggling. They are confused because they have taken wrong decisions. They are not getting a direction in time of need, that they don't know what means, what is the particular thing God wants them. And the Lord is telling us through the word of God, who has learned God's will without wisdom? If God is not giving them wisdom, and if we are not being led by the Holy Spirit. And that is why all those who are struggling to take any decision in their life, the important thing is pray for the gift of wisdom and pray for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Because we read again, this is in the book of Baruch, where if we are taking any decision without the direction of the Lord, what will happen? How miserable will be our life if we are not getting the direction from God? If we are not being led by the Holy Spirit, whatever we are doing, wherever we are turning, it will give us a lot of confusion and problem in our life. Unless God himself is guiding us in our life, wherever we turn, it will create a kind of a confusion in us. That's why we need the gift of the Holy Spirit. We read in the book of Baruch, this is chapter 3 verses 9 onwards. Let's read Baruch 3 from 9. "Hear the commandments of life, O Israel. Give ear and learn wisdom. Why is it, O Israel, why is it that you are in the land of your enemies, that you are growing old in a foreign country, that you are defiled with, that you are counted among those in hate?" 12. "You have forsaken the fountain of wisdom." Why you are struggling? Why you are in a foreign land? Why you are in a place where God may not have sent you? Because you have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. Again, we read now 16 to 18, the same chapter. "Where are the rulers of the nations and those who lorded it over the animals on earth, those who made sport of the birds of the air, and who hoarded up silver and gold in which people trust, and there is no end to their getting, those who schemed to get silver and were anxious, but there is no trace of their works. What does it mean? There are many people who worked very hard, who were very rich once upon a time. Now they have nothing. I have heard people boasting about their past inheritance, that their forefathers had great property, 1,000 acres of land, big plantations, big hotels, big mansions, big rented houses, so many things, but they have nothing. Why did they fail? Why their treasure did not last? Why many things that they were doing in the past, they are not able to establish? How did those who were once upon rich and fell away and even became very poor? And we read now, this is verse 28, Baruch 3:28. So they perished because they had no wisdom. They perished through their folly. See, the Lord is telling us, people perish if they have no wisdom. So are you struggling to take a decision in your life? You don't know where to go? God is willing to pour out His wisdom to us, which enables us to make a proper decision. So what we need to do? We need to pray unceasingly for the gift of wisdom and for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please pray after me. Holy Spirit, I love you.
I love you.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Holy Spirit, I love you.
Holy Spirit, I love
you. Fill me with your wisdom.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Holy Spirit, I love you.
Holy Spirit, I love you.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Holy Spirit, I love you.
Holy Spirit, I love you.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Fill me with your wisdom.
Imagine if the Holy Spirit comes upon us. This is Psalm 104 verse 30. Not just us, the face of the earth will be completely changed and transformed. Psalm 104 verse 30. If the Holy Spirit comes upon us, He comes with all the gifts. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created. And you renew the face of the ground. Whatever may be the situation, maybe anyone who is asking you for a direction, pray for them, so that they may be filled with Holy Spirit and the gift of wisdom, then the gift of faith, then the gift of thanksgiving. So if anyone is struggling and they wanted to take a decision in their life, the gift that you can give them, not a decision. You don't want to give them decision, because through baptism, the Father, Son and the Holy Spirit is inside everyone, and the Lord is able to direct to them. What we need to tell them? Tell them four things. The first thing, believe in God. The second thing, have a heart of thanksgiving. And the third thing, pray for the gift of wisdom. Then the fourth aspect, pray to the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is the provider of all these gifts. And the Holy Spirit will guide them, because the Holy Spirit is inside a person forever. John chapter 14. Verse 16 we read, John 14:16, and I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate to be with you forever. And that prayer of Saint Paul, once again let's read it. This is Colossians chapter 1 verse 9. This is the prayer for anyone struggling to take a decision in their life. For this reason, since the day we heard it, we have not ceased praying for you and asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. So if anybody is asking you, and Father, I need a decision, or asking you, Mom, I want to know what is God's will, what you have to do, ask Holy Spirit to take over this person. Put that person's name before the Lord and ask the Lord to fill this person first of all with the gift of the Holy Spirit, with the gift of wisdom, with the gift of faith, with the gift of thanksgiving, a heart of thanksgiving, and the Holy Spirit will direct them. Sisters and brothers, let me finish with one of the word of God with this. I was in Kenya for 8 years Then I was praying to the Lord, Lord, reveal to me your will. I need to get your direction. I don't know now where to go, what to do. And as I was praying, one religious sister sent me a message and she said, Father, I'm getting a word of God for you. And she sent Acts 23:11. There is nothing else. She just wrote Acts 23:11. I think this word of God is for you. And I read and I came to know this is the word that helped me to take a decision. Let's read this word of God. That night,
the Lord
stood near him and said, keep up your courage, for just as you have testified for me in Jerusalem, so you must bear witness also in Rome. This was a direction since from Kenya the Lord sent me to Rome. And how did the Lord reveal this when we were praying? Is not anyone, it is through the word of God that gave the direction. What I am saying, God knows you are struggling. He has an answer in through different ways, through the word of God, through your people, through your spiritual father. He can speak to you. What we need to do, pray unceasingly and help those who are struggling in decision making, and he will guide you.